when coming to the next presentation, which will be pre-recorded from Sally Kling from India. And the topic is effect on Abel Moshe's Esculentus pot extract on hyperlipidemia in humans. So we are coming to the education of the products and the traditional knowledge, which has been handed over from one generation to the next. The thing is fine.
All right. And I am also audible to all of you right now.
That's good.
Okay. Good evening, good afternoon, or good morning, whatever the timing is in your country, to all of you. My name is Dr. Lalit S. Jazania, and I am teaching as assistant professor in DBS PG College, Dehradun, India. So first of all, I offer my hearty gratitude to the organizers of World Wood Day Virtual Symposium 2021 for giving me an opportunity to present my work in front of the legions tonight. As it is quite visible on your screen, the topic which I have selected today is based on my work, and that is the effect of Abel Moshe's Esculentus pod extract on hyperlipidemia in humans. And this topic coincides with topic 4, that is forest product utilization. I will be running through this work based on these contents: objectives, introduction, parameters. I will be giving the details about the Abel Moshe's Esculentus, methodology, lipid profiling, result, discussion, conclusion, and references. So through these contents, I will be moving ahead. The objective of the current study, what I took as a study was, I tried to find out the solution of hyperlipidemia based on the pod extracts of Abel Moshe's Esculentus. Now this plant, Abel Moshe's Esculentus, is commonly called as okra or gumbo, and it is usually grown in tropical and subtropical countries as a vegetable crop. But before it was identified as a vegetable crop, it was growing in wild in the forest. So the current studies aim to find out the ability of Abel Moshe's Esculentus pod extract to reduce lipid content. Lipid content, when it increases in the blood, it leads into hyperlipidemia. So this is the this is my college where I teach, and this is the work site. If I introduce this concept which I was working upon, so I had shown two arrows over here, and these two arrows are in opposite direction. That means one is the problem area, that is hyperlipidemia, and another one is I try to give a probable solution for hyperlipidemia, that is through Abel Moshe's Esculentus pod extracts. Hyperlipidemia, it is high lipid in human blood. When the lipid contents like low density lipid, high density lipid, triglycerides or cholesterol, when it increases in the blood, it accumulates in the blood, blocks the blood vessels, and then the blood pressure of the patient increases. That can lead into the heart attack as well as the brain stroke. And that's why I took this hyperlipidemia as a very serious disorder, disease, which is occurring most of the people because of the hypertension. And then there are medications available in the hospitals. And there are medicines which are available in the hospitals, but I tried to give an initial stop to this hyperlipidemia through Abel Moshe's Esculentus as far as possible. The different parameters of lipid profile are as follows. If we go for a lipid test, lipid profiling test to a diagnostic center, then these are the serum lipids which are present in the serum of the blood, that is LDL, HDL, high density lipid, serum cholesterol, serum triglycerides. Now all of them or few of them increases in the blood because of the differential lifestyle which occurs. LDL, I'm just giving you a briefing of all these parameters, then I will move ahead with the plant and then methodology. low density lipids. We all are aware, they are very minute lipids which are present in the blood, and they accumulate in the walls of the blood, and it is considered as a bad cholesterol. Now this is considered as a bad cholesterol because it causes atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis is something when this LDL accumulates inside the blood vessels, and then it causes the blockage of the blood vessels, increased blood pressure, and then that again leads into the brain stroke or heart stroke like that. So LDL is considered as a bad cholesterol. HDL, this is another parameter of lipid profiling, HDL, high density lipid. Now this high density lipid is required by our body. It should be not less than 60 milligram per deciliter of the blood. And it is considered as a good cholesterol because it carries the different cholesterol from different parts of the body to the liver, and then removes the liver removes those cholesterol. So HDL has to be there in some proportions in the blood. And then the liver removes those extra cholesterol out of the body. So LDL is considered as a bad cholesterol. HDL is considered as a good cholesterol. Now, coming on to the serum cholesterol, this is the third parameter which is being tested on lipid profiling basis. Cholesterol is a type of body fat, or it is a lipid cholesterol. Now the serum cholesterol, it is measure of high or low density lipoproteins which are present in the blood of the human beings. So this cholesterol cannot be in high quantities. This is the structure of the cholesterol. The cholesterol has to be removed, otherwise it causes the similar problems like HDL or HDL. Serum triglycerides. Serum triglycerides are fats found in the blood, and our body uses it for energy. An alcohol, when combined with three fatty acids, then it becomes a triglyceride. And this triglyceride also increases the risk of heart disease if it increases in high quantities in the blood. So whether it is LDL, whether it is HDL, whether it is serum triglyceride or cholesterol, all these four has to be in optimum amount in the blood so as to prevent us from different hypertension or high blood pressure and the brain stroke or the heart stroke diseases. Now, it is very simple when we go to some hospital that these are the parameters which are increasing. The doctor will medicate us, will give us medicine, and then we can reduce it. But it is good if we take some natural remedy for it. So I heard from somewhere that this plant, that is Abelmascus esculentus, have got some properties to reduce the lipid content. And I came into this work after that. Now this plant, Abelmascus esculentus, is we all know that it is lady's finger. In tropical and subtropical warm countries, it is largely consumed as a vegetable. But I don't know what about the temperate countries. It might be available there also. It's a perennial herb and belongs to the family Malvaceae. And it attains a height of 6.6 feet with 10 to 20 centimeters long leaves. It can be easily identified with the help of these yellow flowers, which are solitary or axillary in position. But the main concerned area here is with the pod, because these pods were taken by me as a source to reduce the lipid content of the blood. So this is the biological details about this plant. And this plant is a kharif crop, which is cultivated in summer seasons, monsoon seasons, and it is harvested in September and October. Now, to test the reducing capacity of this plant, I had a methodology. I developed a methodology. I will show you something, whether I don't know whether you are able to see this or not. Let's see. If I take this lady finger, this is the pod, and if I cut it from the center like this, so it is longitudinally cut. It. We cannot cut it transversely. We should not cut it transversely. So longitudinally, it has to be cut from the center like this. So as I have shown it here in the figure also, these pods are longitudinally cut. And then we see that the sticky mucilage, which is present in the center of this pod, will start dropping out slowly. And we have to take a beaker, and then we have to dip this pod directly longitudinally into this beaker, like this. So it will float, but if I take 5, 6, or 7 pods like this, then they will adjust and they will be longitudinally placed. And we have to leave this beaker overnight so that all the content which is present as the mucilage inside this beaker, is inside this pod, will be released into the water content of the beaker. So here is the methods of developing the pod extract. I cut these pods longitudinally, kept these pods in the beaker along with the normal drinking water overnight, left it overnight, and then I developed the, in the morning, I got this pod extract. So this is the pod extract which has been developed every day, and I continued to drink this pod extract, and I, for 1 month, I selected myself as one of the patients, and then one more patient I selected. Just two samples like this I have prepared. That is, for 30 days, I drank this pod extract for 30 days, empty stomach in the morning. And previous night, I used to prepare the pod extract in the same process which I have discussed here. Now, after 30 days, which when I was continuously taking these pods, so I took the readings after 7th, 14th, 21st, and 28 days. So four readings I took, and one control reading, that is before taking the extract. So this was the lipid profiling. The blood was taken out. The blood is selected, and through automatic robotic machine centrifugation and then biochemistry analyzer. This is the biochemistry analyzer just behind my image. So we went for the lipid profiling test of the two samples which we have selected. Now, if the we see the results, now these are the results and discussion session. Blood sample one, when control reading was taken, that means without any ingestion of pod extract, these were the readings, 137 milligram per DL. But after 7 days, when I continuously took this pod extract, it reduced to 98, 89, 85, 97. That means within these four readings, at the Wednesday or the 28th day, that is approximately 1 month, there was decrease in serum triglyceride. There was decrease in serum cholesterol. There was decrease in HDL. There was decrease in VLDL. There was decrease in LDL. VLDL is very low density cholesterol. It is also available in a lipid profile test. But the only limitation I saw is that this HDL is required, but it is also reducing. While others like serum triglycerides, serum cholesterol, VLDL, LDL cholesterol, they all are reducing, but along with that, HDL also reduced. So there are different ways, different food habits. We can take different types of food later on to increase the high density lipid cholesterol of the body because it is required. It is considered as a good fat. So if I graphically show this diagram, so the serum triglycerides, serum cholesterol, HDL cholesterol, these three were continuously coming down on 7, 14, 21, and 28 days. This is a graph for triglyceride cholesterol, HDL cholesterol. They also went down. The concentration also went down. And this is the reading for the second and blood sample. These control readings, 7, 14, 28, and 21st and 28th day, the same pattern was analyzed in the second blood sample of another person. There was decrease in the lipid profiling of the second sample also. So only the limitation is HDL, high density lipid, they also reduce. In normal way, a normal person should have around 130 to 159 milligram per deciliter of LDL. A normal person should have 60 milligram per deciliter of HDL. Like this, the serum cholesterol should be less than 200 ml milligram per DL, and the serum triglyceride should be 150 milligram per DL, less than that. So these are the normal optimum readings for different types of blood profiling. And here I found that the ingestion of this pod extract can reduce the different contents of the profiling of the lipids. Now the conclusion is when we orally ingest the pod extract of Abelmascus esculentate, it reduces the lipid content, all that is cholesterol, HDL, VLDL, LDL, and also the ratio is also there within the reports. My results coincide with these two workers. They have already examine the tannins, terpenoids, flavonoids, and glycosides, which are responsible for the pharmacological effects of albolmescus and esculentus. And there are certain substances found in the okra pod, that is mucilage, okra pectin, and okra fibers. These fibers actually combine when they bind with the cholesterol and HDL or LDL, and then they take it to the liver so that the liver can remove the extra cholesterol out of the body as toxin. So these are the references. And that's about my work. And thank you very much for the once again for organizing team WWT Virtual Symposium 2021. And also I would like to thank Tabassum Mansari for her motivation. Now the house is open for questions, if any, or improvements, whatever you feel like. Am I audible?
You couldn't hear me before. So thank you very much for this interesting presentation. It's a good example that it's very important to hand over the traditional knowledge related also to medicine to the descendants, and also in this way to educate the young people to make also use of the natural healing possibilities of nature. As we
thank you very much.
Thank you very much.